Thank you. album no video make that video. Thank you.
Christ. I'll be going. Okay.
Benson.
Thank you.
Oh. You can kindly take your seats. Good morning, everyone. Thank you, everyone, for making it from across London, across the UK, different parts of the world, to celebrate the life of a great young man, Benson KWAKU, MENSAH. I don't know, when I woke up this morning and I saw that it was raining after the last few days, which, you know, London, we have been having pretty good weather this summer. And, you know, the rain decided to come out and it's pouring. Like, this is good old UK weather. But I can't help but to think that even the heavens and the skies know that today there has to be some tears. And just knowing that, you know, today's a bittersweet, sad day, but we're here to celebrate the life of a great man. And to mommy and daddy, the siblings, Nyamin, come on. So just to, time is not on our side and we need to try and stick to time, so I'm gonna please. I know there's so much to say, there's so much to share, but we have to try and stick to time. I know, so anybody that'll be reading a tribute, please don't be offended if at any time we do try and hurry you up. I know it shouldn't be the case, but we do need to try to stick to time. So as we begin, I'd like to please call on the Reverend Kenny McCarthy to come and give us an opening prayer. Thank you.
Good morning, everyone. Shall we rise up to pray? Isaiah 57, verse 1 to 2 says, good people die, and no one understands or even cares. But when they die, no calamity can hurt them. Those who give good lives find peace and rest in death. Also, in the New Testament, Revelation chapter 14, verse 13 says, then I heard a voice from heaven say, write this, happy are those who from now on die in the service of the Lord. Yes, indeed, answers the Spirit. They will enjoy rest from their hard work because the results of their service go with them. And finally, I read this verse. 1 Thessalonians chapter 4, verse 13 to 14. It said, our brother and sister, we want you to know the truth about those who have died, so that you will not be sad, as are those who have no hope. We believe that Jesus died and rose again, and so we believe that God will take back with Jesus those who have died believing in him. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you for this time. This is the celebration of life of our dear brother, son, cousin, family, friend, colleague, Benson, KWAKU, MENSAH, BONSU. We want to thank you for his life. We want to appreciate you for your goodness and for the life that he has spent in you, Lord. Lord, he's joined the clouds of witnesses And Lord, we commit this service before you, and we ask, O God, that the power of the Holy Spirit, everything will move according to the will, the counsel of God in Jesus' name. Amen. That Lord, our dear brother, will rest in you in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. Lord, we bless you. We commit everyone that will be speaking, everyone that will be sharing, everyone that will be talking, that the Holy Spirit will take them over. And that, Father, at the end of the day, we'll have cause to give you all the glory, all the honor, and all the adoration. And the people of God say, amen and amen.
Can Tracy Sackler and Benson please give us the reading?
Jesus, and I understand we'll only be singing the first stanza, just only because of time.
Shall we be on our feet, please?
Let's be upstanding.
Oh!
So at this point, I'd like to invite Benny Bonsu to come in. Apologies, Martin Williams is going to do a reading and then Benny will come up after. Thank you, Martin.
Revelation 21, verses 3 to 7. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, "Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men. And he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them, and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow, nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away." And he that sat upon the throne said, "Behold, I make all things new." And he said unto me, "Write, for these words are true and faithful." And he said unto me, "It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is the first of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcomes shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son."
Thank you. So at this point, to read the biography and eulogy, can we please welcome Benny Bonsu.
Thank you all for coming out to celebrate the life of our brother, Benson KWAKU from MENSAH. I know he would have been happy to know that you're all here to honor him and celebrate his life today. My name is Benny Bonsu, and Benson was my partner in crime, my best friend, and also now my guardian angel. Benson was born on the 8th of June, 1988. Youngest of five to Reverend Henry and Reverend Agnes Mensah-Bonsu. Benson attended the Woodbury-Down Crew School and Holy Trinity Church of England Primary School in Tottenham. His secondary school education continued as his sophomore when he got to secondary school, where Benson excelled in his academics and also his sports achievements. He was selected to represent the Borough of Burnley, where we are now, and England in athletics and in basketball. As since once more, Benson was also a massive part of our choir, and he sang in the KWAKU. Benson achieved a scholarship to continue his studies in the United States in his teens, where he attended the main high school and completed his university education at the George Washington University in Washington, D.C., where he studied and earned his bachelor's in business administration, marketing and sports management. While at GW, Benson held several roles within the student movement on campus. This included the president of the Multicultural Business Students Association, president of the GP Urban Music Association, member of the Sports and Marketing Association, member of the GW Undergraduate Business Association, and a member of the Black Students Union. As sad and as heartbroken as we all are, I would like to take this opportunity to remind us all of the light and the gifts that Benson was to us all. Benson was also known as Creative Bonsu. For those who have known him since he was a young man, his street music name was AC Dizzle. The best music producer we ever had in Tottenham, if you didn't know. He respected his mom and dad highly, and he looked up to his older brother, Kajun, as his role model. "Pops, there was nothing he wouldn't do for you." and ordering his good sister. To see your face would make him feel at ease, knowing everything was going to be okay. And for Wafi, his fabulous brother, everything is, Wafi would like this, Wafi would love that, Benny is just in the mama. Wafi would like that. Benson also loved his cousins, Amma Wafi, Marcus, Jackie, Sarah, Candy, Michael, Yao, Hanan, Fiona, Frida, Michelle, Kelvin, Jeffrey, just to mention a few. He loved you so deeply. He wanted to make you all so proud. And not a day went by without a touch sharing a story about growing up behind the Tottenham police station. Benson was a fierce athlete, a passionate music producer, committed community youth leader, a mentor, a godfather, a great friend, and most importantly, a unique, unforgettable, compassionate, and loving adopted brother to many people. His friends, Dimoy, Dayo, Marlon, Joel, Kamnam, Michael, Olin, Justin, Sasha, Tracy, Simon, Ogo, Sarah, they will tell you that Benson brought joy to every room he walked in. Benson made friends everywhere he went. These friends were not your high and high kind of friends. These people who he loved and they continued to love Benson deeply. These friends became family. Benson always gave people he cared about 110% in everything. If you needed him, he would be there with questions asked. Benson gave so much to the world. I wish you all had the opportunity to see the impact he created. At the age of 16, before he left to go to the United States, Benson helped me develop a youth program for the leaders in training. As a result, we worked with over 100 young people right here from Tottenham and since we were small. Benson and I worked with these students daily to keep them on the streets and in their books. He saw these boys and girls as his extended siblings. He wanted them to be successful. He wanted them to prove the teachers wrong. And most importantly, he wanted them to make themselves proud. So we collaborated with his favorite football club, Tottenham Hotspur. Harrogate Youth Service and the Metropolitan Police. All of these students went on to complete their GCSEs and went on to university. Some became bankers, tax directors, TV stars, and Grammy-nominated music producers. The program helped me develop later became the KICS program that was launched by the Premier League nationally to all football clubs. It started from my mother's kitchen, whilst Benson was fighting with my mom over fried plantain and beans. Over the years, Benson went on to work as one of the youngest directors for the Fiat Group, producing some of the biggest campaigns in the UK and beyond for the Fiat 500. To join his dream organization, which was Twitter, as a sports partnership manager for Europe, Middle East, and Africa. Benson loved working with athletes, sharing his knowledge and helping shape their careers through the magic of social media. And he was the best at it. I am not saying this because I am his sister, but because he was an award-winning industry leader. In his position, Benson championed equality for women in sports. He worked with the Premier League footballers for the Black Lives Matter campaign. He worked with the Basketball Africa League to launch the Rwanda. He helped me develop and launch NFL Africa with the NFL Global Team. He also developed that famous Mumsy campaign for Mother's Day with Troy Deeney and supported and became a voice for marginalized groups. Everywhere Benson has worked, his colleagues have loved him. Quite a few of them are here today, so thank you for coming. From his colleagues at Fiat to his family, Twitter family, they're really going to miss him. His presence was felt far and wide across the organization and beyond. Benson was a light in every sense. As his manager would describe him, his energy was contagious, his kindness was pure, and his laughter was so electric it would lit up the meetings from London to Ghana, Ghana to New York. Benson had found a home at Twitter. TJ Akshola and Amy Lumpfield, I can't thank you enough for making his dream come true and being there for him from the beginning to the end. Your support never wavered, and I will never forget your kindness to him when he most needed it. I keep thinking back to our first trip on a Jupiter the robot scheme. when he was in secondary school. I was the group leader to him and his friends, and I'm sure the PD teachers made me the group leader. 10 black boys and me, camping and cooking in the wild and climbing mountains. Just imagine a whole bunch of black people in the middle of nowhere climbing mountains being chased by cows. It was a sight. When I got home, I couldn't even tell mom and dad where we'd been. So we pretended it was the worst trip ever. But we laughed so much that God knows how we even passed that assessment. When Benson came into my life, I knew my life would forever be changed. My life wasn't my life, it was his. I loved having a younger brother, and there wasn't a day you would see Benson without Benny, or Benny without Benson. One of us was always around the corner, or on FaceTime. He was me, and I was him. Benson would describe him to his friends as the enforcer. He would tell them, you wait till Benny gets here. She will finish you. And it was true. His favorite line when he wanted something that he, when he wanted something, or just to put fear in people. There isn't one struggle or one achievement that has happened in my life without having Benson right next to me or right behind me or vice versa. We were a team. Although we all felt Benson was taken too soon from the world, I know that Benson lived a beautiful life and has changed the world for the better. Benson's life was a love story because we're all here and we're present and radiating and beaming so much of the love he poured into all of us. This grief isn't just sadness, but also love Benson gave every single one of us. Benson is shining a light on everything in the world he touched. Benson was a gift and an angel. If you had the opportunity to talk to him, spend time with him, or even listen to him, he would know that he would be in our lives forever. Benson, you passed away on a Tuesday. I'm a man. Today, the 25th of August, is my birthday. We are saying goodbye, but celebrating your life as well. I will miss you, Benson, every single day of my life, and I feel so lucky to have shared an incredible memories with you. Thank you for always being there when I needed you most. Thank you for pushing me to do and achieve more. Thank you for encouraging me to be the best version of myself while you were here. Thank you for making me and everyone here a better person for knowing you. As you made me promise, I will continue to build your legacy through the causes you cared about and give a voice to those who needed it most through the lessons you've taught us. In the word of Bohan, Benson's colleague, when you see Benson at 34 years young, I see someone who has lived more, loved more, and inspired more than many people do in a lifetime. That was the soul of Benson. That was the greatest gift he gave to us. Benson, KWAKU from Pro Mensa Bonsu, aka Creative Bonsu, aka Bizzle, aka Benz. I am heartbroken, but you made me promise to keep it together to the end. I and everyone here love you now and forever. Rest well, and we'll see you again soon. Make sure you have the welcoming party ready when we arrive. Benson, I will never forget you like you told me not to. And I will always love you today and forever. Your jollof rice and your ride or die, Ben.
Thank you. So we'll be having a sermon soon, but we're going to sing the first stanza of Captain of Israel Post. And I'll invite Pastor Kingsley to lead us in that. You've got your programs, it's in there at the hymn section.
Captain of Israel Post. Oh.
for the sermon.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Amen.
The Lord is good.
All the time.
You are come feeling the Lord is good.
All the time.
Hallelujah. Our brother Benson is only sleeping. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
And I believe strongly that one of these days we will meet him. If you believe that, shout a big amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. I want you to quickly open your Bible to the book of Isaiah chapter 57 verse 1 and 2. Isaiah 57 verse 1 and 2 before we pray. The righteous perish, and no man layeth it to the heart. And merciful men are taken away, not considering that the righteous is taken away from the evil to come. He shall enter into peace. They shall rest in their beds, each one of them walking in uprightness. Father in heaven, this is your word. I pray, O God, for revelation, knowledge of your word, and touch my tongue with a ghost of fire to minister to your people in the language they may understand, that at the end we live here knowing that we have hope. In Jesus' mighty name, I pray, and let the believer shout a big amen. The other day, Paul said in the book of Philippians, chapter 1, verse 21, to live is Christ, but to die is gain. And I have never come across any man that have ever made gains of business or whatever you can name it, and the person start crying. The same way, I want to encourage everyone of you that we've not lost our brother. Praise the name of the Lord. So Paul said, for me, to live is Christ and to die is gain. It's gain because there are so many troubles in this world. And I personally believe that when you listen to the bios of the young man, you can see clearly that God is with him and he is with God. Somebody shout amen. There are three types of death. Number one, death in the world, which are called natural death. Natural death. And that one, whether you like it or not, everybody will die. Praise the name of the Lord. Whether somebody kill you, whether it's a witch or by accident or whatever, every one of us will die. And in the book of Luke, we all know about the story of the rich man and Lazarus. The Bible says that Lazarus died and went to the bosom of Abraham, and the rich man also died and went to hell, and he was suffering and was trying to convince Father Abraham to tell Lazarus to dip his finger in water to catch his tongue so that he can quench his whatever he was going through. And Abraham said, no, where you are and where we are, there is a far distance. Child of God, you are here because God loves you. I didn't hear amen.
Amen.
And if you die today, I believe strongly because of the good things you have done and what you are doing in this present, the Lord is with you and you are not dead yet. And then the second type of death I will talk about is living dead. Living dead. And I want to read a scripture in the book of Ephesians chapter 2 verse 12. It says that at that time you were without Christ, being enemies from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenant of promise, having no hope and without God in the world. So there are so many people walking today, you can see them drinking, they are eating, they are enjoying themselves, but they are dead. They are dead simply because they don't have Christ. But you and I, who have Christ today, I want you to understand that you are alive even when you die. I said it in here, amen.
Amen.
When you die as a Christian, you are not dead, you are just sleeping, and one day you wake up. Somebody shout a big amen. And that is what I want to encourage you with today. And the third one is the death in the Lord.
the dead in the law. The dead in the law. I want to read quickly Revelation chapter 14, verse 12 and 13. Here is the presence of the saints. Here are they that keep the commandments of God and the faith of Jesus Christ. And I heard a loud voice from heaven saying unto me, write, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord from henceforth. Yea, saith the Spirit, that they may rest from their labor, and their works do follow them.
Praise the name of the Lord.
Their works do follow them. I have heard a lot of things about this young man, and I believe that he has done so much for the Lord. And for that reason, I am so glad in my heart that Benson is not dead, but he is living. If you agree with me, shout a big amen.
Amen.
And young man that is here, the son of my voice, there are three biblical metaphors of life. Number one, life is trust. In other words, God has entrusted it to your hands. Even your very life doesn't belong to you. Praise the name of the Lord. And so whatever you do with your talent and your gifting and the monies and everything that God has given you, one day you will make account of it. Praise the name of the Lord. And number two, life is a transit. It's a transit. This is not our final home. Somebody shout amen.
Amen.
We will meet one day. We will meet together. Hallelujah. And so sometimes when I look at people rushing to make wealth and boast of them, to build a house with 11 bedrooms or 10 bedrooms, you alone and your wife and your children, how many rooms can you sleep in a day? Praise the name of the Lord. Praise the name of the Lord. So don't behave as even Methuselah died at the end of the day. And so don't live your life as if you remain on this earth. I'm speaking to somebody in this house. Young man, you need to put yourself together and know that there is an account you make one day. Praise the name of the Lord. And then we have the last one. Life is a test. It's a test. Whatever you're going through, every now and then, God is testing you. Praise the name of the Lord. And those of us that have lost our dear one, even in this situation, God is still testing our faith. I didn't hear amen.
Amen.
Whether you will stand there and put your hand on your head and cry and shout as if that everything is gone. But I want to encourage you that our brother is not dead, but he is just living. Amen. And every one of you that is here, the son of my God, if you are serving God, serving with all your heart, and trust me, when you die today, a day will come that you will rise up again. I pray for everyone that hears the sound of my voice, that let this sound and echo into your spirit, that you will put yourself together, and I declare in the name of Jesus Christ that we cancel predictions of men, every assignment of the devil against your life, I override it in the name of Jesus Christ. You will not die just a mere man, but you will die as a child of God. In the name of you who died and rose up triumphantly, Jesus Christ, the Son of God. You are blessed and you cannot be kept. In Jesus' name I have prayed. And let the believers shout a big amen. God bless you.
We're going to have the tributes now, and the first one is the tributes from the parents. And can we please be outstanding? Reverend Henry and Reverend Agnes Mensah Bonsu. And Reverend Agnes Mensah Bonsu will read this tribute. You can sit down.
Praise the Lord. It's written by myself and Reverend Henry Samples, the parents. Children are a gift from the Lord.
They are a reward for him. Children born to a young man are like arrows in a warrior's hands. How joyful is a man whose quiver is full of them. He will not be put to shame whom he confronts the accusers at the gates. Every minute of the day, someone leaves this world behind. We are all in the line without knowing it. In academic belief, we as aged parents should not be writing to you to you. You should be writing to you, encouraging us to graduate. The tables have turned. As some person sudden departure, as he said, for eternity is not only shocking, but has come at the worst possible time. The last of our five children was our pride and our joy, giving us all the help we need at home. A struggling individual in the prime of youth, full of energy and vivacity. We never expected him to live as so bereaved at this time. But he was so beautiful at birth or in infancy that he was called a Bokua instead of by some people. A handsome, loving, caring, respectful, polite, and affectionate baby last, helpful, very independent, reliable, responsible to the role of a son. Great memories we have, but not all can be shared just for you. Koko Frimpong was a bundle of joy, a sweet voice that echoed. He was the love at home, the wonderful fragrance of God's goodness to be around him. It was such a great delight to be around, an epitome of care and concern. Benson was always willing to lend a hand to all who were in need. His obedience and cooperation was so very complete. His praise rang on the lips of all who knew him. He had to make his maker proud. To him, no price was too hard to pay to be the loving son God wanted him to be. He was an angel sent from heaven to us. He was the strength and booster of our faith, always there for us, especially his sick father. He exchanged his comfort for our pain. Benson was an institution that did not just exist or live, but built broken arrows. Benson was named after the Archbishop Benson Lagosa in blessed memory. He dedicated him and prophesied about his life with an unction declaration. We are not surprised he had a unique personality and possessed the qualities he had. KWAKU Frimpong exhibited so much professionalism in everything he did, always advising, if you have to do it well. Adam, be strong and brave always. Sporting a big and infectious smile. Benson was a beacon of light, a bright, shining star, who was pleasant to all and sundry. As a child, he had a funny way of showing appreciation for favors. He would thank us beforehand and repeat his mantra, "I've already thanked you, so you can't refuse me." I've used this belief as a subject of my sermons on many occasions. He always gave a beautiful gift and money and on special occasions. One Mother's Day, when he was only 9, our baby Lars gave me a card with many uplifting words outstanding, such as, I quote, "Mom, you are the only nurse the NHS could not provide." I call these words whenever they fit appropriately into my sermon. While going on a trip, a school trip to Pandao, when he was 10 years old, he asked me for postage stamps. A few days later, a postcard arrived with the message, "Dear father, I'm having a lifetime fun. The bedrooms are big, and it is Tuesday night. I miss you, love from Benson." And you put all the stamps on one card. On one of my birthdays, he returned from Woodbring with a beautiful portrait of himself on the plate. He was so excited to present it to me. I said to him, "You give me your photo instead of me on the plate." You can see it in the brochure. On the 6th of March 2018, Benson surprisingly asked us for kente and Ghanaian sandals. He claimed that he was attending an event and had chosen to wear clothes depicting the African origins. He was the only one in traditional African clothing, very colorful and outstanding. The emptiness you have left in our lives cannot be filled. You are such an irreplaceable son. What biblical principle did we fail to observe? We engage in constant prayer, fasting, and sowing seed to sanctify many altars. Those seeds have yielded fruit for many barren wombs, terminal diseases and chronic illness, persons in coma, even those on the verge of being deported to their countries of origin. We pray for and God work miracles through us. That the sovereign Lord showed your death to happen affirms Romans 8:28. All things work together for good for those who love God, those who are the called of God and His purpose. A few days to his going home, Benson woke up 1:30 a.m. shouting, "My Jesus, my Jesus, deliver me from this demonic trap. Deliver me from this demonic trap." I said to him, "Son, Jesus has heard you." He carried on. "It is a trap, mommy, it is a trap." His sister and I managed to calm him down. He went to Paris. A homegoing of a good friend from home has left an indelible mark on family and colleagues. I grieve. A sudden passing, immeasurable. Benson had everything to live for, but God, in His infinite wisdom, chose to call him home. We may never fathom why such a healthy and vibrant young man would succumb to death in that manner he did. Our human understanding may never yield a solution to our quest for answers, but as Christians who believe in the loving God, we rest assured it is what he intended, what was intended. It will be good to so have our son here, giving us the love and the care we have enjoyed. Living with him, alas, God wanted it differently. Benson, just as his siblings are, was a child who gave us a cause to worry about, not to worry about anything. He was a decent, respectful, obedient child whose life was the epitome model child. Benson's last few words, when we visited him, sitting opposite, looking into my eyes, and said, "Daddy, I want to hug you once more. Mommy, give me a hug." He gave a very tender touch. In our grief, tears incessantly rolled down our cheeks. We can spare the occasional smile, looking back on the good memories Benson left us. Our tears will be litany of thanks to God for the 34 years we enjoyed with Benson. We know that he is resting joyfully in the arms of the Father. Rest well, Benson KWAKU from home. Our noble baby lass, you will forever remain in our hearts. Till we meet again, Mom and Dad.
you, Mommy. So we're going to continue with the tributes, but before that, just a gentle reminder, if you do have your phones, just check that it's off or it is on silent. And as time is not on our side, I'm going to invite, for the next set of tributes, it will be from Benson's siblings. And as you come up, if you just kind of introduce yourself, so we can try and get a good flow, because time is not on our side. Thank you. So his sister will come up next. His sister will come up.
In 2005, the Johnson and MENSAH BONSU families gathered in Seattle, Washington for Noel's graduation from medical school. Benson was the self-appointed entertainer that weekend, and he was in his element. I remember he hooked up the karaoke machine and started singing and dancing to I Feel Good by James Brown. His dance moves were hilarious, and I laughed until tears ran down my face. Benson would spend summers with me in Maryland. And if you know me, you know he loved to dance, and so do I. Our love for music connected us in a special way. We would have dance competitions in my living room and practice our moves for the next party. He was my dance partner in crime, and we had so much fun with it. I remember the day he came home and told me that Apple was no longer willing to work with him on his work visa, and they had let him go. We cried together that night. They crushed his dreams, but not for long. Benson began making plans for his return to the UK, and it was in that moment that I realized that baby P, KWAKU Benson, my little brother, was now becoming a man. Benson was a handsome young man. His eyes and his eyebrows, his chocolate skin, and even his platinum strands, yes, those gray hairs, they made him very attractive. His giant smile would catch your attention, his outgoing personality filled all spaces, and his kindness exemplified his pure heart. He lived on purpose. Benson was a marketing genius. He was smart, very talented, and full of ideas. Anything he aspired to in life, he accomplished. I'm so proud of Benson and everything he stood for, whether it was Black excellence, professionalism, or equality in sports. Benson was diagnosed with colon cancer in the midst of the pandemic. It was the most heartbreaking news, considering he had been asymptomatic for months. He took initiative to advocate for himself and sought help. As a family, we rallied together, prayed, and fasted as he began treatment. Our journey with this disease was just beginning. We knew that he could always rely on pups, We are here, Kojo and I, to get you through the darkness on difficult days. Our family FaceTime calls were an outlet to share stories, reminisce about the good times, and take his mind off the pain. It still amazes me that B could find the strength to take care of mom and dad and countless others, even while enduring his own health issues. I am so proud of everything that Benson accomplished in his time here on Earth. And I have realized that Benson was a gift from us. Sorry, he was a gift to us from above. He truly was heaven sent. He touched the lives of so many people, and I am proud to be able to call him my brother. I miss him dearly. Benson was a man of integrity. He had a heart for the people, and he served his generation. There was nothing he wouldn't do for anybody. Yes, even a complete stranger. He left an indelible mark on every person that he encountered. Benson's unfortunate experience in getting the right medical attention put him on a quest to inspire all of us to live good and healthy lifestyles. Let his lesson be to us that we listen to our bodies. If you're experiencing any type of pain, go see the doctor. Schedule an annual physical exam on your birthday or at the beginning of the year. Exercise consistently and eat the right foods so you can live your best life and thrive. May the light that Benson brought into this world illuminate our paths forever. Baby P, KWAKU Benson, B. There's no more pain, bro. And I'm sure the fried plantain and kettle in heaven is top notch. Save me a plate, please. I hope they serve soup more in heaven. I will always love you, and your spirit will live on in my heart forever, bro. We will always be the fat five, and our bonds will never be broken. Rest in heavenly peace, my brother, my love. Rest well.
Good afternoon, everyone. Evidently, I need my security here for this. As I put this tribute together on behalf of Benson, I realized that there aren't enough words in my vocabulary and that I lack the eloquence to do justice to his memory and truly capture his impact. By the way, I'm Kojo, I'm his oldest brother. There are far too many expansive adjectives to describe him and to describe who he was, but I'll try. This man was kind, he was loving, he was assertive, forward-thinking, selfless, patient, focused, ambitious, courageous, and dynamic. That's Benson. Benson, aka B, was also affectionately referred to as a care tree, which is tree in our parents' native language, Ghana, for last born. Now, most of you are probably laughing at me because of my poor tree, but short man, that's all you have over me is your tree speaking. Despite being the last of five, his presence and his influence was far more significant than one-fifth of our siblings said. There's a 14-year difference between Audrey in age and Benson. Audrey the eldest. But he was undisputedly the baby of the family. But his representation and impact in our family accounted for far more than his fair share. He was a combination of the best of us, my parents' best work thus far. Benson held himself to a very high standard. This was true for all facets of his life. He leveraged his work ethic and his moral compass to guide his professional and personal life. The fruits of this are evident in his early career success as well, as all the awards and accolades that he garnished throughout his short professional tenure. It's also evident in all of those of you who are here today who travel from all over the globe. Thank you. Benson was a man with a sophisticated palate for music and fashion. His style was sharp. Even his style of car spoke to who he was as a person. B was the type of guy aunties, Ghanaian aunties will call a fine young man. What's interesting is Benson's joyous personality and disposition was infectious. Always smiling, always upbeat, putting everyone else at ease. He laughed with his entire mouth, his face, and his chest. You didn't even need to know what he was laughing at. Just seeing him and hearing him laugh would put you doubled over laughing in a frenzy. He had this innate ability to lift us all up. Some of you may mistake his constant smile and his jovial spirit for a man who did not have any challenges or problems in his life. If this is your understanding of who B is, you are greatly mistaken. What I offer to you is to change your thinking and view it from this perspective. Benson operated with this belief system that he was afforded two things in life, a chance and a choice. It's not that he didn't have struggles and pain. He absolutely did. But what he did every single day, when given a chance, he made a choice to be who he was. Many of you knew him to be this joyous guy, and you'd be naive to believe that's how he woke up every day. That was an active choice to live this way each and every single day of his life. B was the epitome of selflessness. He led with servitude, and he wasn't hung up without the credit. He was a man of honor, mature and wise beyond his years. Respect, dignity, and grace, love, were always core tenets in Benson's daily life. It's not just that Benson exhibited these behaviors and traits, but he delivered them as superhero levels. These were just some of his superpowers. There was a 12-year difference between me and myself. So when I left for high school in the U.S. nearly 3 decades ago, Benson was barely in preschool. When I graduated college and began playing professional basketball in Europe, we took the opportunity to get more time with one another. Each spring break or half term, he would join me wherever I was in Europe. We recently were reminiscing about the time when he was 11 and he flew out to meet me to spend a week in Belgium. We had a blast, but he did not come prepared. His suitcase had 2 pairs of underwear, a pair of flip-flops, and the rest of the suitcase was all candy. Needless to say, he got kitted out that whole week with a whole new wardrobe during that trip. He shared how that was the best week of his life growing up. Just the other day, I won't ever forget that he said that. In January of 2021, Benson was diagnosed with stage 4 colon cancer. Our family was devastated, yet we had resolve and hope. We all knew in our hearts of hearts that he would pull through, and that this was just another opportunity for God's grace to shine upon our wonderful family. Over the last 18 months, I was afforded the beautiful privilege of getting closer with Benson and spending a significantly more time than we ever had in the past. Our time consisted of attending major movie premieres, sporting events, eating at Turkish restaurants, going to Tottenham Hotspur games, and watching NBA games in the early hours of the morning. Our conversation ranged from trying to understand why so many Ghanaians love to drink tea. Why Ghanaians misplace the word he for she and she for he. We tried to understand how Justin Robinson wasn't on the 2012 Olympic British basketball team. We discussed his professional aspirations and how he'd like to go back into ownership. But Twitter was his dream organization, and he was in his current role was his dream role. One of the things that bothered me so much was that the rest of the world didn't get to see the rise of this juggernaut. During my multiple trips to London, what really crystallized for me was that Benson was far more dynamic than I'd ever given him credit for. A man wise beyond his years, and kind beyond reason. He gave to those who asked exactly what they needed, but he had so much more. It's not that he withheld anything, because that's not who he was. But his scope of knowledge, wisdom, willingness to give was so expansive that he had an innate ability to serve and deliver just what he needed. Benson wasn't performative, and he didn't placate. If he did something, he did it out of love and a desire to help. He was clear and honest in his communications and effective in delivering his message. Benson would often quote a saying that my father would deliver: if you are going to do something, do it well. He lived by that mantra. There was excellence in everything that Benson did. Benson asked for me to be a proxy and a second opinion regarding many of his decisions around his health care. I took this assignment very seriously, and I realized that it's probably more because my wife was a physician and he saw her expertise in his space, but he valued my opinion in many other things. Bibi was weeks away from purchasing a home. And our trips entailed visits to properties and these large events to view future developments. The beautiful thing about Benson is that he did not make me feel as though it was a burden or an unsurmountable weight on me. It was the greatest honor of my life being a brother to this man in this difficult time. Benson's battle with cancer was the most courageous physical, mental, and emotional display of fortitude that I've ever seen. Another superhero trait was his bravery. Not because he wasn't fearless, but because he was terrified. Yet he faced this with strength, grace, and dignity every single day, even through to his last breath. He had reconciled the idea that early death may be a thing. So it was not death that bothered him. It was the dying that he had a challenge with. Even in his last days, he would extend love and grace to everyone who came to visit him. This included the ancillary staff in the hospice and the hospital, those who came to clean and the maintenance folks. And they would come in the room, and even when he didn't have strength, he would lift his hand up and acknowledge them. one hospital. Everyone knew his name and they knew his. He's like, that's just me, bro. That's just me. In the time since Benson had transitioned, I've received and witnessed multiple phone calls, text messages, social media posts, and comments from strangers speaking of the impact that Benson had on his, on their lives. He mentored many, both professionally and personally, and gave support to friends and family, acquaintances, the such. Whenever he needed, he would be there to fulfill it. A phone call, as phone calls and messages flooded in, my mother said one night, she mentioned, this man Benson was peculiar. She said he was peculiar. That caught me off guard and had me thinking all night about that description of him. So I looked up the definition. Definition, peculiar. Different to what is normal or expected. Here are some of the synonyms. Special, strange, unusual, odd, distinctive, distinguishing, unique, unmistakable. I typically had only heard the term peculiar used in a pejorative manner, but the more I thought about it, this was the perfect description of who Benson was. He was peculiar. This is not an overstatement, and I'm not saying this because he's my brother, but Benson was simply the best person I have ever known. A beautiful person that we cannot ever backfill or replace. And I have enjoyed knowing that he's looking down on us with my beautiful baby son Noah and my grandparents. I love you, B. Great scripture. Have I not commanded you? Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Joshua 1, verse 9. I just want to say one quick word. I know time is fast, thanks. But I want to recognize my family real quick. Pops came through with all types of, when we need something, he's got to connect every single time. We actually put this program together, and if you knew the last 72 hours, he hasn't slept. As we all prepare what is the equivalent of a wedding in a week, he knocked that out. Audrey and my mother, the last 3 weeks of Benson's life, the three of us sat there in the room with him. And every time I would raise up to get something, because he was moving, they had already beat me to a punch. The way my father and my mother have galvanized our family, because even during the time of sorrow, somehow families find a way to bring up controversy and conflict, and we have not done that. And that speaks to who we are, and we've honored Benson's memory in doing that. So I love you all for that. Even you, Nana Bonsu, with all your stories, you delivered. Love you all. Thanks.
Hey, what's up, everyone? I am Yafir.